Lewis structures are a particularly useful technique to show bonding in covalent compounds. Let's begin with something that isn't covalent though, magnesium. It's a metal. Typically it's found in ionic compounds, but we can use it to illustrate what a Lewis structure is. The symbol, magnesium, stands for the nucleus and inner shell electrons. And then about this symbol, we've got two dots. Those are the valence shell electrons. Magnesium's in group 2A, has two valence electrons. Aluminum is in group 3A, so it would have three dots. And I didn't mention this with magnesium, but it doesn't matter where you show those two dots. It could be up there, they could be below the symbol, one on the left, one on the right. And the same thing is true of aluminum. It doesn't really matter where you show those three dots. It's the number of dots that's important. Sometimes we refer to Lewis structures as electron dot structures. We're showing the valence electrons as dots. Here, let's look at the interaction of hydrogen and chlorine. It's going to form a covalent compound. We don't have a metal here. Both are non-metals. Hydrogen is in group 1A. It has one valence electron. Chlorine in group 7A, seven valence electrons. And the octet rule still applies. Even though they can't transfer electrons, they're going to work out a sharing that obeys the octet rule. Well, for hydrogen, because it's in the first period, its magic number is not 8, but 2. And hydrogen says, hey, chlorine, if you would just share one of your electrons with me, then it looks like I could have two electrons. And chlorine is anxious to work out this sharing too, because with 7, it only needs one more to have an octet. So here's what happens. And I've shown the hydrogen electron as an X so that we can sort of keep track with our bookkeeping. And these two atoms now attract one another out of this tendency to satisfy the octet rule. And the sharing of two electrons we can represent with a dash. It's a covalent bond, a single covalent bond in this case. Let's look at chlorine. We mentioned that chlorine likes to travel around in pairs rather than as a single atom. If it did travel around as a single atom, it would be pretty unstable. It'd have 7 electrons, 7 valence electrons, anxious to have one more, and so that means that it would be pretty reactive. And if there were metals around, it would form an ionic compound. Or if another chlorine atom were around, then it would have the chance to share electrons. They each need one more electron, and so here I've drawn the structure showing them sharing two electrons. This chlorine thinks that it has 8. This one is happy with 8. It obeys the octet rule, and so two chlorine atoms work out this sharing of two electrons. We could call this the covalent bond structure. The electron dot structure and the covalent bond structure. Oxygen, O2, exists. And whenever something exists in nature, chances are it's pretty stable. And with covalent compounds, chances are awfully good that it obeys the octet rule. So let's see if we can work out the octet rule using the Lewis structure for oxygen and see why O2 exists as two atoms bonded together. Well, oxygen is in group 6A, 6 outermost electrons. Here's another oxygen. It too has 6 outermost electrons, and I've started with the worst case scenario. We know they're going to share electrons, and yet we haven't placed any between these two oxygens. The only way this one can get two more electrons is from its neighbor. And so we'll put two X's in the middle. And the same thing is true of this oxygen. The only way it can get two more electrons is from this neighbor. So here I've placed four electrons between these two oxygen atoms. They each have four of their own and four that are being shared. They think that they have eight and satisfy the octet rule. The sharing of four electrons could be represented by two dashes. We'd call it a double bond or a covalent double bond. Let's look at carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide exists. Chances are it satisfies the octet rule. Let's see if we can show the Lewis structure to confirm that. Carbon's in group 4A, four valence electrons, oxygen in 6A. Here I've started with two of carbon's electrons in between the two atoms. And oxygen says, hey, that's a wonderful arrangement. It has eight, six of its own, and two that are being shared by the carbon atom. But carbon still only has four, needs four more. The only place it can get four more is from its neighboring oxygen. So let's throw four electrons in from the oxygen. And as we do so now, we see that each atom has two of its own and six that are being shared, a total of eight. It satisfies the octet rule. Here we'd have a carbon-oxygen triple bond then, the sharing of six electrons. Nitrogen has a similar structure. We know that nitrogen runs around not as single N atoms, but as N2. And if we were to draw the covalent bond structure, we'd come up with this, a triple bond between the two nitrogens. See if you can do that. Draw the covalent bond structure, and then just the way we did up here, come up with the Lewis structure to support this triple bond. What would you say about the relative strengths of these? We've looked at the single bond, an oxygen-oxygen double bond, and now we see a triple bond. And if a bond is an attractive force, well, I hope it makes sense that a triple bond is going to be a pretty strong bond. And it's very fortunate for our world that nitrogen exists as N2 with the triple bond holding these two atoms of nitrogen together, because it's a very stable bond and 78% of our atmosphere is N2. It means that 78% of our atmosphere is unreactive, is inert, and that's very fortunate for us. Let's do one more thing. Let's look at an ion. Let's look at the cyanide ion, CN-. That negative charge up there means that it's obtained an electron from somewhere. Maybe there's a metal around, like sodium, that gave up its electron so that CN could have a minus charge. Well, chances are, if CN with a minus charge exists, it satisfies the octet rule. Let's see if we can come up with the Lewis structure. Carbon, group 4A, four outermost electrons. Nitrogen is in 5A. So I've put five circles up here. And then we needed one more electron because of that negative charge that cyanide got from sodium or some metal. So I've represented it with a box. Well, how are we doing? Nitrogen has eight, so we're not too bad, but carbon only has four. The only place it can get four more is from this nitrogen. So let's throw those in, and now we see that carbon has two of its own, six that are being shared, so it's happy. The nitrogen, six that are being shared, and two that it has for a total of eight. So here's the Lewis structure, or the electron dot structure, for CN-. And it would be represented by a triple bond. This would be the covalent bond structure of this polyatomic ion, cyanide.